Welcome back. If you've just joined us, you're watching Channels Television, celebrating 21 years of professional broadcasting. This is the News at 10, and here's a reminder of our major stories tonight. Police and Department of State Services ask INEC to postpone the Edo State governorship election scheduled for Saturday. National Council of State and Police Council confirm appointment of Ibrahim Idris as Inspector General of Police. Federal government insists on going ahead with plans to concession the nation's four major airports. And Zimbabwe's High Court overturns a police ban on demonstrations in the capital Harare following a suit filed by anti-Mugabe activists. Just a quick reminder to you that all our top stories are on our website, channelstv.com, and on youtube.com/channelsweb. And do log on to m.channelstv.com to view us live on your mobile device. You can also download the Channels TV app for Android, iOS, and Windows phones from their respective stores. Besides the news and updates, the Channels TV app has an eyewitness feature. We encourage you to use it to share those pictures, videos, or news of happenings around you. Just install the app, then tap and swipe to reveal the eyewitness menu and follow the instructions.
Airtel, the smartphone network.
We can now share with you some of those pictures. And let's begin with this one from Gbanani local government area of Akwa Ibom State, showing a bad road. Our eyewitness reporter wants the government to repair the road. And here's one from the Forks Road in the Aba area of Abia State. Our eyewitness reporter wants the government to find a solution to the recurrent flooding problem in the area. And this picture is from Mabunuori Street in Isherin North, Lagos State. Our eyewitness reporter wants the government to pay some attention to the inner roads in the local government area. And from Agege here in Lagos State comes this picture. Our eyewitness reporter is asking the government to construct more drains in the area to avoid consistent flooding. And this photo is from the Maryland area of Lagos as well. Our eyewitness reporter wants the government to look into the flooding problem in the area.
Airtel, the smartphone network.
Thanks a lot for sending in all your pictures. We ask you to keep them coming. Now let's continue with our lead story on the Edo State governorship election. And prior to the announcement regarding security alert, INEC officials and representatives of political parties met in Benin City to finalize arrangements for the polls. In attendance were candidates of the APC, PDP, APGA and Labour parties. The resident electoral commissioner in the state advised stakeholders, including security operatives and the electorate, to adhere to the rule of law. And the National Council of State and the Police Council have confirmed the appointment of Mr. Ibrahim Idris as the Inspector General of Police. Before now, Mr. Idris had been in the position in an acting capacity. The Governor of Jigawa State, Abubakar Badaru, who briefed State House correspondents on the outcome of the meeting, said the decision was unanimous. The Council also approved the appointment of 6 National Commissioners for the Independent National Electoral Commission to bring the number of commissioners to 12. Also approved are 5 new commissioners for the National Populations Commission to represent the remaining geopolitical zones in the country. Council was also said to have deliberated on the state of the nation's economy and how to move it out of recession.
They started arriving as early as 11 o'clock in the morning. And at the last count, only 3 former Nigerian leaders, including President Ernest Shenekal, General Abdusalami Abubakar, and Dr. Goodluck Jonathan, made it to the meeting. Dr. Jonathan was a signature of all as he makes his first appearance into the council chambers since leaving office. Also present were past chief justices of the Federation, many of the state governors and deputies of those absent. President Muhammadu Buhari, who is chairman of the council, tabled the ratification of the appointment of Ibrahim Idris as the Inspector General of Police, and council was said to have unanimously given a nod to that.
There was almost unanimous acceptance of his own confirmation. So the police council do resolve to confirm the inspector, the acting Inspector General of Police, Ibrahim Idris, on this meeting today.
While six persons were confirmed as INEC commissioners, five others were appointed for the National Population Commission.
For the purpose of clarity also, we'd like to let you know that Mohamed Haruna was appointed from North Central, AVM Ahmed Tijani Mwazu retired from Northeast, Abubakar Nauche from Northwest, Professor Okechukwu Ibeanu from Southeast, May Agbamuche Umbu from South-South, and Dr. Adekunle Ladipo Ogumola from the Southwest as new INEC commissioners.
And on what the federal government is doing about the current recession in the land.
The council was so confident, and we also approved of the measures taken by the presidency and the federal government in ensuring that Nigeria goes on the path of recovery as quickly as possible.
The National Council of State is the highest constitutional advisory body in the country, and Nigerians are waiting to see how the advice from the past leaders will indeed move the country out of its current recession, even as they make their exit from the meeting. Chukwuma Onwekwusi, Channels Television News.
To aviation, and the federal government says there's no going back on its plan to concession the four major airports in the country. The Minister of State for Aviation, Hadi Sirika, who met with journalists in Lagos, explains that the government has already indicated interest to concession the Lagos, Kano, Abuja and Port Harcourt international airports to improve their capacity.
The atmosphere within these airports are not anything to write home about. They are not the ideal. It is extremely difficult for us to attract passengers to create the necessary harbor. Today we are doing 50 million passengers per annum. We believe with the right things in place, Nigeria has the potential of doing 70 to 100 million passengers within 5 years. And research has shown that about 40% of passengers like to transit through fantastic airport. Dubai is a classical example. The duty-free in Dubai is $1.2 billion. The money is simply not there. So we must concession.
Let's cross over to our Abuja studios now. Here's Linda Akigbe. Linda.
Hello, Ijeoma.
Hey.
The Director General of the National Biosafety Management Agency, Dr. Rufus Ebigba, has refuted claims that genetically modified rice has been commercially released into the Nigerian market. Dr. Ebigba, who was speaking at a news conference in Abuja, enjoins Nigerians to disregard such rumors.
The National Biosafety Management Agency wishes to unequivocally state that there is no iota of truth in the said post, and restates that no genetically modified rice has either been imported or released officially into the country. And as a matter of fact, there is no genetically modified organism anywhere in this country commercially. It will suffice to note that there is no genetically modified rice that has been commercially released anywhere in the world. All the genetically modified rice, particularly the golden rice, is still on the confined feed trial.
The Nigerian army has arrested a Boko Haram suspect on its wanted list. He was apprehended alongside two others in Jugba local government area of Yobe State. The acting army spokesman, Colonel Sani Usman, says the suspects, Mohammed Bulama, Ado Abba Mohammed, and Mohammed Ukeyama, were arrested with the help of the local vigilantes He notes that the terrorist has confirmed his photograph on the wanted list, revealing that he specializes in rearing animals for the terrorist group. Meanwhile, the troops of 4th Brigade Nigerian Army have also arrested a wanted suspect identified as Gabriel Obuje, who is alleged to be responsible for the recent attack on oil installations in the Niger Delta. Meanwhile, the military says it's fully prepared to respond to possible terrorist attacks at the nation's airports and assured passengers of their safety at all times. The Chief of Air Staff, Air Marshal Sadiq Abubakar, confirmed this today at the Nnamdi Azikiwe International Airport after officers conducted a simulation test of counter-terrorism strategies. It appears like a real-life situation, but it is a simulation by the Nigerian Air Force, which showcases its combat readiness to counter terrorism at the Nnamdi Azikiwe International Airport. The exercise begins with troops taking vantage positions at the airport, while others are deployed into the terminal building of the airport. Under the command of the regiment's commander, the troops storm the airport to arrest the terrorists. With the arrest of a terrorist, the Chief of Air Staff speaks on his observation of the exercise.
I'm very happy that we've been able to test the plans we have for this airport, and whatever gaps there are, we'll be able to quickly go back and debrief and see where there are areas of difficulties. You'll notice some people are wearing this with orange. Those are the evaluators. They are here to really see how workable is the plan. Is it a plan that can really be effective? And you can see some of them putting their notes there behind, you know, having observed the entire process.
The Air Chief, however, explains that there is no threat of terrorist attack on any of the nation's airports.
We are not anticipating anything. Like I said, this is just an exercise. It is very important that you evaluate your plan from time to time, or else you might have some gaps in what you have put together. So this is not just because we are anticipating anything. No. If you have to do when you are anticipating, then it will be too late.
The simulation, which is aimed at testing the combat readiness of the Nigerian Air Force to counter terrorism, will be replicated across the country. And still ahead on the news at 10, economists ask federal government to explore Nigeria's informal sector as a viable option for economic recovery. That's some business news. John.